Carpal bones on the right and left side give attachment to a small flexor retinaculum. This is attached laterally to the tubercle of scaphoid and crest of trapezium. Medially, it is attached to hook of hamate and pisiform bone. In addition, it has a deep slip which is attached to medial side of the groove of trapezium for the passage of flexor carpi radialis. On the medial side is a superficial slip also attached to pisiform, and it covers the ulnar vessels and nerve as these enter the palm. Structures passing superficial to flexor retinaculum from medial to lateral side are ulnar nerve, ulnar vessels, palmar cutaneous branch of ulnar nerve, tendon of palmaris longus, and palmar cutaneous branch of median nerve. Structures passing deep to flexor retinaculum are tendon of flexor pollicis longus in the synovial sheath, 8 tendons of flexor digitorum superficialis and flexor digitorum profundus, 4 each. Median nerve lying superficial to the tendons. The tendon of flexor carpi radialis is passing between the superficial and deep slip of the flexor retinaculum. Flexor retinaculum on lateral side gives attachment to muscles of thinner eminence. These are abductor pollicis brevis, flexor pollicis brevis, and opponens pollicis. Adductor pollicis is not a muscle of thinner eminence, as it is not responsible for the eminence due to its deep position. Flexor retinaculum on medial side gives attachment to 3 similar muscles of hypothenar eminence. These are abductor digiti minimi, flexor digiti minimi, and opponens digiti minimi. Adductor pollicis arises from capitate base of second and third metacarpals as oblique head, and from shaft of third metacarpal as transverse head. The two heads get inserted into the medial side of base of proximal phalanx of the thumb. 4 tendons of flexor digitorum superficialis pass deep to the flexor retinaculum, pass across the palm. At the respective metacarpophalangeal joints of 2nd to 5th digits, each tendon gets perforated by tendon of flexor digitorum profundus, so that the tendon of flexor digitorum superficialis gets divided into 2 slips to be inserted into sides of shaft of middle phalanx. Thus, flexor digitorum superficialis has 8 slips, has 8 slips of insertion, 2 each into 2nd to 5th digits. The tendon of flexor digitorum superficialis is perforated by tendon of flexor digitorum profundus and gets divided into 2 to get inserted into the shaft of the middle phalanx. And tendon of profundus gets inserted into the base of the distal phalanx. The 4 tendons of composite flexor digitorum profundus pass deep to the flexor retinaculum. They also pass deep to the tendon of flexor digitorum superficialis, perforate through the tendon of superficialis, and get inserted into base of distal phalanx of 2nd to 5th digits. These tendons are the only ones to cross distal interphalangeal joint and are its only flexors. These 4 tendons of flexor digitorum profundus also give origin to 1st and 4th lumbrical muscles. The 1st and 2nd are unipennate, and 3rd and 4th are bipennate. These pass on the lateral side of respective metacarpopharyngeal joint to get inserted into the respective extensor expansions.
Correct.
Palmar interossei. These are four in number. These arise from one metacarpal each and are adductors of digits at the metacarpopharyngeal joint. The mnemonic is P for Palmar and AD for adduction. The first interosseous is a small muscle as its action is done by adductor pollicis. It arises from base of first metacarpal and inserted into proximal phalanx of the thumb. Second, third and fourth arise from second, fourth and fifth metacarpals respectively. Third metacarpal has no Palmar interosseous. Third metacarpal has no Palmar interosseous, and so no Palmar interosseous is inserted into the long middle finger, and no Palmar interosseous is inserted into the long middle finger. Second Palmar interosseous is inserted into extensor expansion of index finger. Third Palmar is inserted into extensor expansion of ring finger, and fourth Palmar is inserted into extensor expansion of little finger. Dorsal interossei. These are abductors at metacarpopharyngeal joints. These are four in number and arise from adjacent sides of two metacarpal bones. So in between five metacarpals, there are four dorsal interossei. The first digit or thumb and fifth digit or little finger have their own abductors. So there are four dorsal interossei for second, third and fourth digits. Axis of abduction and adduction of digits passes through the middle finger or the third digit. So the middle finger, whichever side it moves, is abducted. So it needs two abductors. Index finger or second digit gets attachment of first dorsal interosseous. Middle finger or third digit gets attachment of second dorsal interosseous on lateral side and third dorsal interosseous on medial side. Ring finger or fourth digit gets attachment of fourth dorsal interosseous. So second, third and fourth digits, second, third and fourth digits, middle three digits get insertion of first, second, third and fourth dorsal interosseous. Middle finger gets two dorsal interosseous.